this attorney there who did. So there's Thompson and I, we are friends. We devoted our lives to excavating the glories of Egypt. And last year we discovered the tomb of Amenhotep. An untouched tomb, Mr. Holmes. Over 4,000 years. Joseph and I, we are the first human beings to set foot in it since the day it was sealed. Can you imagine what that meant to us?
Don't you bite my toes.
Joseph was beside himself. He wanted to open the mummy case immediately. But it was wrong, Mr. Holmes. The case had to be opened carefully, delicately. We quarreled. I tried to restrain Joseph physically, but he broke loose from me. He ran to the case and opened it, and then he staggered and dropped dead.
As he opened the sarcophagus.
Yes. There were no witnesses to what had happened, Mr. Holmes. But in our struggle, Joseph had suffered bruises. I knew what the police would bring.
And so you removed the mummy of Amenhotep and substituted the body of Joseph Thompson instead.
It was the only way I could get the body out of the tomb. Mr. Holmes, I didn't mean to kill Joseph. It was his heart. He always had a weak heart.
You say he staggered, Professor. But what did he do as he staggered?
He grasped his throat as if he were choking.
What? Would you oblige me by removing the cover of the sarcophagus?
Yes, sir.
Stupid.
It wasn't our fight.
No. Traces of the poison may still be found in the body, even after mummification.
I say, Holmes, you don't think there's any of that poison left in the needle, do you? Because, well, if so,
the next few minutes will determine that, Watson.
What? Well, how's old Amenhotep doing? I bet he's
doing well. Stupid. Stupid possum.